Okay, yesterday हमने क्या किया था? We started with certain properties of liquids और उसमें हमने one property जो discuss करी थी that was evaporation, that is the change of the liquid state into the vapor state at any temperature, ठीक है? और उसमें factors भी हमने करे कि किन factors के ऊपर evaporation depend करता है. Then the second which we did was heat of vaporization. Today we are going to do the third property which is vapor pressure. Now what do we understand by vapor pressure is? To understand vapor pressure, let's take a closed container like this, ठीक है? और इस container के अंदर we are going to take water. Let's increase the temperature of water, ठीक है? Now what is going to happen is that there is going to be certain liquid which is going to get converted into the vapor state, and that vapor that will be present at the surface of the liquid, ठीक है? So over here this vapor is not going to get evolved from this closed system. So you can say that it is going to hit the wall of the container, condense and come back in form of liquid. So we say that in this container there are two processes which are taking place. One is evaporation, and the amount of evaporation which is taking place per unit time, that is known as rate of evaporation. ठीक है? और second जो हमारे पास है, the second process which is taking place is condensation. So we say that a time comes when rate of evaporation that becomes equal to rate of condensation. Rate of evaporation becomes equal to rate of condensation. अब ये जब होता है, this process or this point that is known as equilibrium. At equilibrium, the rate of evaporation becomes equal to rate of condensation. तो equilibrium पे जितना भी vapor इसके surface पे ऊपर बढ़ा, that is going to exert pressure by hitting the walls of the container, and that pressure is going to be known as vapor pressure. So if we are defining vapor pressure, how we will define it? Vapor pressure is the pressure exerted by the vapors of a liquid above the surface of a liquid at equilibrium point in a closed container. So that is what vapor pressure is. Vapor pressure that is going to depend upon the following factors. So factors iske kya hoge? Number one, nature of the liquid. If the forces of attraction between the molecules, that is going to be more, less vapor is going to be formed, and hence the vapor pressure is also going to be less. So what are we saying? If more the intermolecular forces of attraction, less is going to be vapor. So we are saying that intermolecular forces of attraction, that is going to be inversely proportional to vapor pressure. ठीक है? Intermolecular forces is going to be inversely proportional to vapor pressure. So second, it will depend upon temperature. जैसे for example यहाँ पे आप ले सकते हो, अगर आप water और C2H5OH का एग्जांपल ले रहे हैं, तो आपे पता है कि C2H5OH पे the forces of attraction they are going to be less. तो अगर forces of attraction less होंगे, this is going to form more vapor, and hence the vapor pressure in case of C2H5OH that is going to be high. Second, the vapor pressure depends upon temperature. जैसे जैसे टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज होता है, वैसे वैसे इंटरमॉलिक्यूलर फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन डिक्रीज होंगे, एंड हेंस द वेपर प्रेशर दैट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. और इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से दैट विद इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर मोर वेपर्स आर गोइंग टू बी फॉर्मड, एंड हेंस द वेपर प्रेशर इज गोइंग टू बी मोर. सो टेम्परेचर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वेपर प्रेशर. ठीक है? टेम्परेचर इज गोइंग टू, मोर द टेम्परेचर मोर द वेपर्स, मोर इज गोइंग टू बी द वेपर प्रेशर. Mathematically, if we are talking of pressure of the liquid, it will be given as N upon V RT, or pressure may be given as CRT, where C that is going to be the concentration. Right? Now all those liquids which form more vapors, such liquids, they are said to be volatile liquids. All liquids which form more vapors, they are said to be volatile liquids. It is also seen that non-polar liquids such as diethyl ether, ethyl alcohol, have high vapor pressure. So we are saying all the non-polar, they have high vapor pressure, right? Or in other words, the organic solvents, they are going to have high vapor pressure because of weak intermolecular forces of attraction. Okay? And liquids like water, that is, when we are talking of polar liquids, the polar liquids, they are going to have low vapor pressure because the forces of attraction between their molecules, that is going to be large. Then, uske baad, the vapor pressure that can be calculated with the help of an equation which is known as Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Now, according to the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, if we are considering the vapor pressure of two liquids, then log of P2 upon P1, that is equal to delta H upon 2.303 into 1 upon T1 minus 1 upon T2. So if the pressure has to be calculated, they have given you the vapor pressure of the one liquid and you have to calculate the vapor pressure of the second liquid. So we can calculate the vapor pressure at two different temperatures, T1 and T2, where T2 that is going to be higher than T1. So this equation, that is known as Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Right? Or you have to do delta H of area, that is going to be the latent heat of vaporization. Okay? Now depending upon vapor pressure, we discuss another very important property of liquids, which is boiling. Boiling. Now when we are looking at the process of boiling, we say that the process of boiling is a bulk phenomenon. Basically what happens in case of boiling is that as the temperature is raised, the liquid that starts converting into the vapor state, or wo jo vapor state mein convert hota hai, those vapors, they appear in the form of bubbles in the bulk of the liquid, aur uske baad those bubbles, they come to the surface and they burst. Theek hai? So boiling point jo hoga, that is going to be, or that can be defined as the constant temperature at which vapor pressure of the liquid becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. Vapor pressure that becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. We know that the atmospheric pressure at STP, that is going to be 760 mm of mercury. So when the temperature of, or the vapor pressure that becomes of any liquid becomes equal to 760 mm of mercury, its boiling point, that is going to be achieved. Now over here, the boiling point of a liquid, we say that it changes with change in external pressure. Right? Just say, for example, we say that at high altitudes, the pressure that is going to be less, right? Because the pressure at high altitudes is less, therefore the boiling point, or the water boils at a greater temperature than 100 degrees Celsius. So if we are comparing the planes and we are comparing the hills over here, it is seen that water on the hills, it is going to boil at a temperature above their 100 degree centigrade, because over here the vapor pressure that is going to be less. The atmospheric pressure that is less. So vapor pressure bhi kam ho jayega. Aur agar vapor pressure kam ho gaya, it is seen that vapor pressure that is inversely proportional to boiling point. More the vapor pressure, less is going to be the boiling point. So higher altitudes, water boils at a temperature not high, below its boiling point. Not high, below its boiling point. Because vapor pressure, the atmospheric pressure is decreasing. So vapor pressure will become equal to the atmospheric pressure at a lower temperature. So on the hills, the boiling point of water or the water boils below its boiling point. 100 degree se kam pe boil karega. Theek hai? Clear ho gaya? Then when we are talking of boiling point and we are talking of evaporation, and when we want to see the difference between the two, let's see what is the difference between evaporation and boiling point. Right? First of all, evaporation, that is a surface phenomena, which means that only the surface molecules, they are going to evaporate in the process of evaporation, whereas boiling point is the bulk phenomena, or boiling is a bulk phenomena. Okay? The number two, evaporation takes place at any temperature. Any temperature, and we have seen that it will increase with increase in temperature, whereas when we are talking of boiling will take place at a constant temperature at which the vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. So these are the differences between evaporation and boiling point. Then we come to the next. What do we understand by freezing point? The next definition which we are going to do, or the property of liquids which we are going to do, that is the freezing point. Freezing point kya hota hai? Ki, we say that whenever melting or freezing is taking place, in case of freezing, the liquid that is going to convert into the solid state, right? So at one point there are both solids and liquids which are coexisting. We say that is the freezing point. So in other words, we can say temperature at which solid and liquid state have same vapor pressure. Have the same vapor pressure, that is the freezing point. Or the point or the temperature at which solid and liquid state coexist, that is going to be the freezing point. Okay? Now over here, amount of heat that must be used in order to freeze, that will be equal to what? Amount of that is going to be the temperature at which it is going to start melting. Okay? So freezing point. और अगर हमको कोई भी एक जैसे हम लोगों ने हीट ऑफ वेपराइजेशन करी थी, उसी तरह से फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट पे जो हीट इवॉल्व होती है, दैट इज नोन एज, या हीट एब्जॉर्ब होती है, दैट इज नोन एज हीट ऑफ फ्यूजन, राइट? डेल्टा एच व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ, दैट इज द हीट ऑफ फ्यूजन, राइट? Then the next property which we come to is an important property, surface tension. What do we understand by surface tension? Surface tension that is going to be the property of a liquid due to intermolecular forces of attraction. So surface tension is due to the intermolecular forces of attraction of a liquid, and all these forces, they are said to be attractive forces, or we use one more term for this which are known as cohesive forces. Okay, now what is happening over here is that if we are taking a beaker filled with water, this is going to have again two types of molecules, one which is placed at the center and this one that is going to be attracted from all the sides because of other molecules present. So it is going to have balanced forces of attraction. Whereas when we are talking of the surface molecule, this surface molecule that is going to be pulled inwards, right? So the forces of attraction which are present over here, they are said to be unbalanced forces of attraction. These unbalanced molecular attraction which the surface molecules they have due to the inward pull, that is going to be known as surface tension. So basically it is a measure of the inward force on the surface of the liquid. It acts downwards perpendicular to the plane of the surface. So if you're talking of the force over here, it is going to act tangential to the surface, or it is going to act perpendicular to the surface. So basically surface tension is the inward pull on the surface molecules to minimize the surface area. That is what surface tension is. Now surface tension, it is going to depend only on the area. It depends only on the area and not on the length. It is going to depend only on the area and it will not depend on the length. What is going to be the factors? Factors which are going to affect surface tension is temperature. It is seen that with increase in temperature, the intermolecular forces of attraction jo hai, wo decrease ho jate. Because of that, temperature is going to be inversely proportional to surface tension. Or if we increase the temperature, intermolecular forces of attraction decrease and surface tension that is going to increase. So temperature is inversely proportional. What are the consequences of surface tension? When we are talking of consequences of surface tension, the first consequence of surface tension is spherical shape of liquid droplets. Spherical shape of liquid droplets. Now what is happening over here is that whenever any drop of liquid that falls on the ground, because of the inward pull of the molecules, all the surface molecules, they are going to be pulled inwards in order to decrease the surface area. So surface area, aapko pata hai ki sabse kam jo hai, wo kiska hota hai? Sphere has the smallest surface area. So that is the reason why jab bhi liquid girta hai, it always immediately form drops. Then number two, another consequence of this is that insects can walk on surface of water without getting drowned. You must have seen ki insects jo hai wo paani ke upar aram se chal sakte hai. Why? Because jo surface tension hota hai water ka, that makes the surface of water elastic. Kyunki wo elastic ho jata hai, as a result of which the insects, they can walk smoothly, because they're very very light, they can walk smoothly on the surface of the liquid. Okay, so that is why they can easily walk on the surface. Then number three, the cleansing action of soap that is also a consequence of surface tension. Now soaps and detergents, due to their lower surface tension, the soaps and detergents, they have greater molecular forces of attraction, therefore their surface tension, that is going to be less. Because of their lower surface tension, they can penetrate into the fibers of the cloth or into the threads of the cloth, thereby pulling dust particles from it. Okay, so cleansing action of soap is also one consequence of surface tension. Then we have a very important consequence, which is the capillary action. What is capillary action? Capillary action is the inflow of water inside small holes or in small capillaries. Like for example, if we take a straw, let's say we take a Coke in this glass or any Mirinda or whatever soft drink you like to have, and we have dropped a straw in it. The straw over here, that is going to behave as a capillary because it has a very small opening. Okay? Ab kya hoga? The liquid molecules at the surface, they are going to be attracted inwards. Same is the case over here, they are going to be attracted inwards. Because of their inward pull, a force, a thrust force is going to act in it, and the liquid that rises in the capillary. This is known as the capillary action. A very good, important, example of this is absorption of water by the roots from the soil. So that is an example again of surface tension. Okay? So ye consequences ho gaye. When we need to measure the surface tension, that can be measured by the formula gamma 1 upon gamma 2, that is going to be equal to N1 D2 upon N2 D1, where gamma 1, that is the surface tension of water. Okay, gamma 1 is the surface tension of water, D1 is the density of water, N1 is the number of drops of water, gamma 2 is the surface tension of the liquid, D2 is the density of the liquid, and N2 is the number of drops of the liquid. So if we know the surface tension of water and the density of the liquid, we can calculate the surface tension of the liquid. Okay? Then the last property which we are going to discuss, that is viscosity. Last one is viscosity. What do we understand by viscosity over here? Viscosity ka matlab hota hai ki resistance to the flow of the liquid. That is what viscosity is. Basically what happens is, whenever we are talking of any liquid, it consists of many layers. Okay? Ab jo niche wale layers hote hai, especially the layers which is on the surface, on the lowermost surface, that provides a resistance to the upper flow. So if these are two flows of liquid which are, two layers of liquids which are present, the downward one, this one is not going to let this flow smoothly. So the resistance which is offered by the lower layer of the liquid to the flow of the upper layer of the liquid, that is what is viscosity. Okay? So viscosity kya hui? Resistance to the flow of the liquid, in simple words, that is going to be viscosity. So let's explain this with the help of an example over here. We are going to take a glass slab, okay, and we are putting water on this. Let's say this is the topmost layer. This is the middle layer and this is the bottom layer. This bottom layer is going to touch the glass slab. ठीक है. Now over here, obviously what is going to happen? This is the bottommost layer. This is going to offer resistance to this, and this is going to offer resistance to this. So this resistance is going to be known as the viscosity. Let's say that this is the area of the glass slab on which we have put water, and this kind of a flow, जैसे ये आप देख रहे हो कि first वाली जो है सबसे आगे जा रही है, फिर उसके बाद ये वाली उसके पीछे है layer, और ये वाली इसके पीछे layer. So this flow of the layers of a liquid in, you can say, in dragging order, that is going to be known as the laminar flow of liquid. It is known as the laminar flow of liquid. Now let's say that this is the difference in position dx. Similarly over here also the difference in position, that is going to be ds. The velocity with which the middle layer is moving, let's say that is v. जो ऊपर वाली लेयर है, that is going to move with the velocity of v plus dv, और जो सबसे नीचे वाली है v minus dv. ठीक है. So when we looking at the force of friction F, that is going to be directly proportional to the area of cross section, and it is inversely proportional or directly proportional to dv upon dx. dv upon dx over here, this is known as the velocity gradient. dv upon dx, that is known as the velocity gradient. ठीक है. So इसका मतलब force is directly proportional to a dv upon dx. ठीक है. और force is equal to eta a dv upon dx, where this eta, that is known as coefficient of viscosity. Eta is equal to coefficient of viscosity. So if we are saying that the area of cross section is unity and dv upon dx is also unity, in that case eta, that becomes equal to force. So we can define eta as the force of friction when the area and velocity gradient, they have the value of 1. ठीक है. Units जो इसके रहते हैं, that is going to be dynes, that is the force of unit, unit of force. ठीक है. Dynes per centimeter square second. And this is known as poise. So poise is going to be the unit of viscosity. Okay, factors on which viscosity, that is going to depend. Number one, it will depend upon intermolecular forces of attraction. More the intermolecular forces of attraction, greater is the resistance to the flow of the liquid, and hence more is going to be the viscosity. For example, if you are comparing honey and water, in this case honey mein jo forces of attraction hai, they are going to be more. Hence we say that honey is more viscous than water. ठीक है. Because the intermolecular forces of attraction in this case, they are going to be more. So honey is going to be more viscous than water. ठीक है. Clear हो गया. Second, it depends upon the molecular masses. Molecular masses, all those liquids having high molecular masses, they are going to be more viscous. All those which are going to have high molecular masses, they are going to be more viscous. And number three, it depends upon the structure and shape of molecules. It depends upon structure and shape of molecules. It is seen that as the branching in the chain increases, viscosity also increases. Right? As the branching increases, viscosity is also going to increase. So this was the last property, viscosity. Now how do we measure viscosity mathematically? In order to measure viscosity, we measure viscosity in terms of coefficient of viscosity, and the formula given is n eta upon eta w, that is equal to d into t upon dw into tw, where eta w, that is going to be coefficient of viscosity of water. This is the coefficient of viscosity of the liquid to be calculated. D is the density of water. T, that is going to be equal to time of flow. dW is the density of water, and tW is the time of flow of liquid. That is equal to time of flow of water. Okay? Or T kya ho jayega? Time of flow of the liquid. So with this we finish our chapter number 5. We will start with chapter 6 in the next class. Next we have to start with thermodynamics.